Well, the hot weather is here. That means summer is right around the corner. That means it's time for several different theater festivals to kick off. And this week here on Arts Pop, we're going to focus on one that has become countrywide known, maybe even worldwide known. It's St. Louis Opera Theater. And here to discuss it with it is fine arts and classical music critic for the St. Louis Post-Dispatch, Sarah Brian Miller. Welcome back to Arts Pop.
Thank you.
I love that everyone gets so excited. June approaches, the opera starts, it's picnic time. The opera's a real tradition, isn't it?
Yes, it is. This is its, I think, 43rd mm-hmm. season, and of opera in English, accessible opera in an intimate setting, mm-hmm. and with one of the world's greatest orchestras in the pit. I mean, it doesn't get better than that.
And it's so approachable because it is often in English. An exciting season.
Always in English.
Some exciting some classics, and mm-hmm. then some new operas here to talk about. So let's kind of run through the season. It starts Saturday night with mm-hmm. La Traviata, the Verdi classic.
Yes, and with an important directing debut by soprano Patricia Racette, who has done the role probably around 100 times in a wide range of productions, knows the opera really well, mm-hmm. and knows how to work with people. She's not one of these singers who wants to see others follow in her particular footsteps, but to help them, guide them to find their own way.
Really make the roles their own,
yeah.
That's for sure. A more modern opera that's going to be there this year, set in Afghanistan and mm-hmm. the wartime, is called An American Soldier, and this is
yes.
a two-part version of this opera.
This is a two-act version. Mm-hmm. That's the world premiere of the two-act version. The original was commissioned by Washington Opera just as one of a series of one-act operas. Okay. And so they have expanded it and done more with it. And it's a story that asks the question, what does it mean to be an American?
Fascinating. To go a little bit more ragtime, I believe, tell mm-hmm. us about, this is one I'm not familiar with, tell us about Regina.
Well, Regina is by Marc Blitzstein. You will hear when you hear the score, you will know that he influenced Leonard Bernstein a lot. There'll be familiar echoes here. The story is from The Little Foxes, the play by Lillian Hellman. You may have seen the movie with Betty Davis. And it's just, what will this woman do? How far will she go to get
married? She's a strong character.
That's an understatement. Yes, yes. She'll do just about anything to get what she wants.
It's amazing. The storylines, when people will do just about anything to get what they want, are pretty fascinating.
And it's got a fantastic cast. Susan Graham, the great mezzo-soprano, is Regina. Mm-hmm. She normally plays all these lovable characters. This time she is not lovable. James Morris, whom I worked with at Lyric Opera of Chicago, he did Votan in Ring Cycles all over the mm-hmm. world, and now he's making his opera theater debut, mm-hmm. Ron Raines, and Susanna Phillips, who's one of the great sopranos in the world today. So it's mm-hmm. a very starry cast for opera theater.
We don't want to get out of here without mentioning the fourth. It is Orfeo and Euridice, and another mm-hmm. kind of classic storyline here.
It is Greek myth. Mm-hmm. Orfeo, whose wife, I always think of it in Italian, Euridice, was bitten by a snake and died, and the gods allowed him to go to Hades, and his music charms the demons, and he's allowed to lead her out, but he's not supposed to look at her.
Mm-hmm.
He looks at her. But then there's a deus ex machina, and she's brought back to life, and it's a happy ending. And this one's a collaboration with the Big Muddy Dance Company, because there's a lot of choreography called for in this score.
All right. It's going to be an amazing season there. I know yes. you're looking forward to it. I know many of you are
yes.
looking forward to it. We are going to link you up to Opera Theater St. Louis's website so you can get those tickets. We're, of course, also going to link you up to Brian's full article. You'll find it, though. Better yet, pick up that newspaper. Today's A&E section of the St. Louis Post-Dispatch. Get your cup of coffee and figure out which, hopefully, all of the operas that you are going to attend this festival season. Brian, thanks for coming back with us here
on
Arts Pop.